ऑनरेबल प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया श्री प्रणब मुखर्जी, सीनियर ऑफिसर्स एंड रिस्पेक्टेड डिग्निटरीज, आई प्रेजेंट बिफोर यू 109 IPS प्रोबेशनर्स ऑफ द 68 रेगुलर रिक्रूट्स हु हैव रिसेंटली कंप्लीटेड 44 वीक्स ट्रेनिंग एट द नेशनल पुलिस अकेडमी एंड हैड देयर दीक्षांत परेड ऑन 28 अक्टूबर 2016. It is a proud moment which will be cherished and a great honor for the National Police Academy to be here today to hear your words of advice and encouragement. The mission of the Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel National Police Academy is preparing leaders for the Indian Police who will lead the force with courage, uprightness, dedication and a strong sense of service to the nation. The training, consequently, is built around this mission, ensuring emphasis on integrity, sensitivity to the aspirations of the people, respect for human rights, high standards of professionalism, and the motto, sensitized police for empowered society. In order to sensitize and orient the probationers, several intensive modules on issues such as gender, communal harmony, marginalized communities, human trafficking, juvenile justice, community policing, and accountability were conducted. Various competency modules, including traffic management, cyber crimes, investigative interviewing techniques, intelligence collection, strategic leadership, and internal security were conducted. The probationers were exposed to a model police station at the academy, thereby giving them a hands-on experience of police station functioning in a simulated environment. Integrated exercises on public order management and investigation of different types of crime were also simulated to equip them with necessary professional skills. Integrated training methodology was adopted to shift the focus from the teaching to skill training and value education. The classroom knowledge imparted to the probationers was applied in the real-world context by conducting various visits and attachments. The probationers have undergone jungle survival and operations modules with the Greyhounds of Telangana State Police, weapon training at the Central School of Weapons and Tactics, Indore, rock climbing and river rafting at the ITBP Academy, Mussoorie, security management at the general elections in Tamil Nadu, large-scale crowd management during the Kumbh Mela at Ujjain, Madhya Pradesh, and correctional administration at the Chanchalguda Jail, Hyderabad, Open Jail, Cherlapalli, and traffic management module at modernized traffic control room in Bangalore. There have been visits to orphanages, homes for differently abled and destitute. With a view to providing a broader exposure to the probationers and giving a context to law enforcement, a wide range of speakers and eminent personalities were invited to address and interact with them. The Vice Chairman Niti Aayog, Dr. Arvind Panagariya, delivered the 31st Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel Memorial Lecture on why growth matters and what must be done to sustain it. Eminent speakers include Honorable Union Home Minister Shri Rajnath Singh, Shri ESL Narasimhan, Honorable Governor of AP and Telangana, Ms. Kiran Bedi, Honorable Lieutenant Governor of Puducherry, Dr. Krishnakant Paul, Honorable Governor of Uttarakhand, Honorable Justice Shri Madan B. Lokur, Shri Pawan Kapoor, IFS, Ambassador of India to Israel, and Shri Prakash Jha, film director and producer, who interacted with the probationers. Police luminaries who interacted with the probationers include Padma Shri Dr. S. Subramaniam, IPS retired, Shri K. Vijay Kumar, IPS retired, Shri Prakash Singh, IPS retired, Director Intelligence Bureau, Director National Disaster Response Force, Director General Central Reserve Police Force, Director Central Bureau of Investigation, Director General Indo-Tibetan Border Police, and Director General Border Security Force. With a view to focus on democratization parallel to regimentation, platforms have been created to facilitate the spirit of free and frank discussions. Sir, these probationers are looking forward to the forthcoming district practical training that they would undergo for 29 weeks from December 2016. During this phase, they will get on-the-job training in police station management by working as station house officers of a police station and also hands-on training in district and subdivision management by closely associating with subdivisional and district level functionaries. In July-August 2017, the probationers will reassemble at the National Police Academy for a period of 8 weeks to undergo thorough debriefing on their field experiences before assuming charge of regular Assistant Superintendent of Police in their respective cadres. Honorable President, sir, your zeal in nation building is well known. You have worked tirelessly towards government schemes for the upliftment of masses throughout your long public life. As Director of the National Police Academy, I thank you for interacting with these fresh IPS entrants. Your initiatives and encouragement would motivate them and be their guiding light throughout their careers. Jai Hind.
सम्माननीय राष्ट्रपति महोदय श्री प्रणव मुखर्जी, सरदार वल्लभ भाई पटेल राष्ट्रीय पुलिस अकादमी की निदेशक महोदया श्रीमती अरुणा बहुगुणा, उपस्थित संकाय सदस्य, 68वें बैच के परिवीक्षाधीन अधिकारी, देवियों और सज्जनों, राष्ट्रपति भवन के इस ऐतिहासिक दरबार हॉल में खड़े होकर अपने प्रशिक्षण के अनुभवों को साझा करने का अवसर मुझे प्राप्त हुआ, इसलिए मैं आज गौरवान्वित महसूस कर रहा हूं। महोदय, हम जैसे ही अकादमी के मुख्य द्वार से प्रवेश करते हैं, हमें एक पत्थर की कलाकृति दिखती है। उसके नीचे माइकल एंजेलो का एक प्रसिद्ध कथन उद्धृत है, जिसका आशय यह है कि हर पत्थर में मूर्ति पहले से ही होती है, कारीगर तो सिर्फ उसे तराशता है। उसी प्रकार दिसंबर 28, 2015 से अक्टूबर 28, 2016 तक हमारा जो प्रशिक्षण हुआ है, उसके द्वारा एक सामान्य नागरिक में से एक पुलिस अफसर तराशा गया है। महोदय, भारतीय पुलिस सेवा का प्रशिक्षण बहुआयामी होता है, जिसमें शारीरिक, मानसिक, बौद्धिक सभी पहलुओं पर बल दिया जाता है। अनुशासन और एकजुटता से काम करते हुए अपने ध्येय को प्राप्त करना यहाँ सिखाया जाता है। अकादमी में उपलब्ध प्रशिक्षण की सुविधाएं अत्याधुनिक है, जिसका पूरा लाभ हर एक प्रशिक्षक को मिलता है। महोदय, प्रशिक्षण मुख्यतः दो भागों में विभाजित होता है, इंडोर और आउटडोर। इंडोर में पुलिस व्यवस्था संबंधित विषय जैसे कि आईपीसी, सीआरपीसी, फॉरेंसिक साइंस और मेडिसिन, एथिक्स आदि विषय पढ़ाए जाते हैं। इन विषयों से यह सुनिश्चित किया जाता है कि एक पुलिस अफसर के रूप में हम समाज में हो रहे अपराधों को न सिर्फ सुलझाएं, बल्कि उनकी जड़ तक जाकर उन्हें रोकने का प्रयास करें। आउटडोर में पीटी, आयुध प्रशिक्षण, रणकौशल, ड्रिल, खेलकूद जैसे विषयों द्वारा एक पुलिस अफसर की भूमिका में हमारे व्यक्तित्व का संतुलित विकास किया जाता है। राष्ट्रपति महोदय, इसके अतिरिक्त विभिन्न अटैचमेंट्स जैसे कि आईटीबीपी रॉक क्लाइंबिंग, उज्जैन कुंभ मेला, तमिलनाडु चुदाओं आदि के माध्यम से भविष्य में आने वाली विभिन्न प्रत्यक्ष एवं व्यावहारिक चुनौतियों से अवगत कराया जाता है। महोदय, जब प्रशिक्षण प्रारंभ हुआ तब सब कुछ बहुत कठिन लगा था, इतने सारे विषय इंडोर के साथ साथ आउटडोर भी, पर समय के साथ साथ आत्मविश्वास भी बढ़ता गया और इसका चरम बिंदु था ग्रेहाउंड जंगल अटैचमेंट। जंगल में 5 दिन रहने के बाद यह आत्मविश्वास और भी बढ़ गया है। महोदय, अकादमी के प्रशिक्षण के पश्चात हम अपने अपने स्टेट कार्डर में 6 महीने का डिस्ट्रिक्ट प्रैक्टिकल ट्रेनिंग करेंगे, उसके उपरांत स्वतंत्र प्रभार में काम भी करेंगे और मुझे विश्वास है कि हमें जो प्रशिक्षण प्राप्त हुआ है, उससे भविष्य की सभी चुनौतियों का सफलतापूर्वक सामना करेंगे। राष्ट्रपति महोदय, इस मौके पर हम प्रतिज्ञा करते हैं कि हम अपने कर्तव्यों का निष्ठापूर्वक निर्वहन करेंगे। जय हिंद।
Honorable President of India, Shri Pranab Mukherjee, Respected Director SVP NPA, Ms. Aruna M. Bahuguna, Joint Director Basic Course, faculty members, and my fellow probationers. It's a great privilege for all of us to be here. I express my gratitude on behalf of the 68th batch of regular recruits to the Indian Police Service to the head of our state for having granted us this audience. In the early morning of 28 December 2015, when the newly recruited girls and boys woke up, it was not just a new day, but also a new world into which they had opened their eyes. The day marked the beginning of 44 weeks of rigorous police training, a training that was designed to push our physical, emotional, and mental boundaries. The regular sessions of physical training, weapons training, battle obstacle and assault course, drill, horse riding, swimming, unarmed combat, changed us in ways that we thought was not possible. Initially, it was difficult for most of us to run even half a kilometer. And by the end of the training, all of us have ran around 16 kilometers. None of us had thought that we would be able to walk 40 kilometers at a stretch with a rifle and a battle load on our backs, or that we would be able to survive for 4 days in the wilderness, in the jungles of Vikarabad, away from the comforts of civilization. All these challenging activities have instilled confidence in ourselves. They were not only physically demanding, but also tested our mental strength and emotional resilience. It has shown us that being sleep deprived or exhausted or even injured need not stop us from completing our tasks and fulfilling our duties. We are taught to take pride in our uniform. But it was during our various attachments, like the Kumbh Mela attachment in Ujjain, the election attachment in Tamil Nadu, that we understood what it signifies. The impact we had on the public when we were in uniform showed us the power we hold and the immense responsibility that comes with it. The indoor classes in penal, procedural, and evidentiary laws, police sciences, IT and cyber security, internal security, criminology, has equipped us with knowledge to deal with the various situations that we'll encounter on the field, and it will stand us in good stead throughout our careers. The tough yet enabling environment provided by our instructors and the academy has been transformational for some of us and has definitely changed all of us for the better. However, the most important takeaway for all of us has been the friends we have made here. We have gone through the thick and thin of the training together. The friendships here have been forged during testing times, and they will hopefully last for a lifetime. I would like to conclude with the old Sanskrit dictum, Dharmo Rakshati Rakshitaha. Dharma protects those who protect it. It is our duty to protect Dharma. And as law enforcement officers, we have pledged to protect the rights of the people and discharge our duties without any fear or favor. Jai Hind.
Good evening. Mizoruna Bahuguna, Director, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, National Police Academy, Officer Trainees of 68 Order 2015 of Indian Police Service, Officer Trainees from Maldives, Nepal, and Bhutan, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you to this historic building, Rashtrapati Bhavan, and particularly to this marvelous hall, which is known from the colonial days, Darbar Hall. This Darbar Hall has witnessed many important events in the contemporary life of Indian people, and also that of a vast multitude of people living in Indian subcontinent, adjoining countries including Myanmar, which was then known as Burma. Sri Lanka, then known as Ceylon, Singapore, up to Aden in the Gulf of Persia. 16 years from this building, from 1931 to 1947, the British rulers, who was designated as the Governor General and Viceroy of India by the British Crown, ruled this vast area. At the midnight of 14th, 15th August, this hall witnessed the birth of a new nation, ending 150 years old colonial rule. In the language of first Prime Minister Nehru, when half of the world was in slumber, then a new nation woke up and began its tryst with the destiny. Again, after 3 years, this hall witnessed the birth of a republic on 26 January 1950, and the emergence in course of time, the largest functional multi-party democratic system which the world has never beheld before. In the last general elections to the 16th Lok Sabha or House of People, more than 800 persons who are entitled to elect their rulers, more than 66% of them participated in choosing 543 members of the House of People or Lok Sabha from snow-capped Himalayas to the wave-ridden Cape Comorin, from forests of Mizoram to the west coast of Arabian Sea, Gujarat. I would also like to take this opportunity of congratulating all of you, particularly Indian Police Service officers, who have very successfully completed one of the most difficult civil service examination, which is acclaimed not only in India but all over the world. It speaks of your academic excellence and merit. I congratulate you. But the real test of your merit starts when, at the end of your, as one of the trainees have very correctly pointed out, rigorous training at the academy, and also connected with that in some other areas, you enter into your real life. All of you, in the next 30, 35 years, will be an important part of our vast administrative structures which rule, govern 128 crores people in 3.3 million square kilometers landed area of India. You are the face of the administration, government. To the people, you represent the state, through you, they look at, judge at the government. Therefore, your role is not only multidimensional, but also complex and complicated. Those days are gone when the job of a police personnel was to maintain public order, to ensure enforcement of law. Today, with the changing concept of the governance, emergence of the concept of the welfare states, various manifestations of this concept in people-public government partnership, role of the police personnel have changed. That does not mean that your core functioning of administering law to ensure rule of law and to maintain the public order is already there. With that, many more ingredients and elements have been added to it. At one point of time, the face of the government was stern administrator, carefully watching whether there is any breach of law, there is any breach of indiscipline, there is any sign of indiscipline, breach of discipline, and you are to administer the discipline and maintain the order, sometimes with iron hands. But today, as I mentioned, the concept of the governance is undergoing rapid changes. And particularly in the last half of the last century till today, that means more than 65, 66 years, are very important in the history of art, because that is the period which historians describe as the period of peace dividends. Because they made a very simple comparison. In the first 50 years of the last century, saw two world wars. In fact, the beginning of the century started with a war between a Western power and an Eastern power, Russo-Japanese War in 1905. For the first time, an Asian power, after many years, proved its superiority over the Western power. And within 10 years of that, the First World War began. Before that, major change took place in Indian context. Capital was shifted from Calcutta to Delhi in 1911, and certain momentous announcements were made in the Delhi Darbar to reverse some of the earlier decisions by the then colonial government. After the First World War, with the signing of Versailles Agreement, and before the Second World War began, the British power over maritime world, that means British maritime power, became supreme with the defeat of Germany and complete ruination of France, which were the two rivals of the British power in Europe. And Russia under the Soviet system, withdrawing itself for quite some time till the beginning of Second World War. After the Second World War, the world, particularly the European powers, especially those powers around the Mediterranean world, they started rethinking and they began reconstructing the war-devastated Europe and also began the process of decolonization along with de-apartheid policies. And the last 60 years, the world witnessed, on the one hand, emergence of various power blocks based on economic power, not so much on military power, like Japan and Germany. And of course, the emergence of two superpowers whose rivalry led to the era of Cold War. But in the last decades of the last century, that Cold War era ended and a new phase began. All of you have noticed the recently held USA general election to the president. And to a considerable extent, the result appeared to be surprising to many, particularly the political commentators. I do not have the privilege of sharing my perception, but the fact remains, if somebody has followed history of Europe and that of North America, particularly USA, in the context of the European superpower rivalry and control over dominance, one factor remains. USA did never have any colonies, and to protect their commercial interests vis-a-vis colonial possessions, which the European powers had, not only England, but Germany, Belgium, France, even Portugal, Spain, all of them. USA did not have it. But they had interests on the commerce, on the industry, on the overall economic power. And therefore, it was natural that in the emergence of the new world order, United Nations, Bretton Woods institutions, and finally the World Trade Organizations established in 1995, supremacy of the European economic power, which some political theoreticians describe as the power of dollars that dominated the large part of the second half of the last century. Major changes have taken place in UK itself with the exit from European Union, Brexit. What would be its impact? How it is going to have its interactions and reactions with the world power and the erstwhile colonial systems is quite interesting to note. And I am exposing yourselves, the role and duties, your responsibilities in the context of the ever-changing world, where almost change is the only constant factor, rest others are not so constant. Constant changes are taking place. Today's police officer is to acquaint himself or herself with cyber crime, which is going to be one of the serious and heinous crimes against humanity, against the concept of privacy, against the concept of the individual secrets and privacy of the individual life is inviolable. Those principles are no longer relevant when you pose them in the context of the cyber crimes. Blackmailing, unknown in the Indian criminal history few years before. Kidnapping. I am not talking of two other major challenges which Indian security forces, primarily the police forces, are to face. One is the problem of insurgency, another is the problem of terrorism, which are closely linked with internal security and external security. Problems of insurgency are from the very beginning. Even during the end years of the colonial rule, it manifested in the northwestern part of India, northeastern part, I'm sorry. There was another tribal issues that was in northwestern, but we are not primarily concerned after partition of India because that is the domain of Pakistan. But which is within our domain, in the northeastern region, the insurgency, particularly the Naga insurgencies, which is considered as the mother of insurgency in northeast, still a major problem you have to deal with it. Terrorism has spread its tentacles all over the world. It is no longer confined to any territorial border. In fact, it has no respect for any territorial border. It has no respect for any religion, for any ideological perception. Only one ideology terrorists believes, that is the wanton destruction of human values. Whatever stands, whatever is considered as a symbol of humanism, they are destroyed by terrorists, whether in terms of life, in terms of property, in terms of traditional civilizational links, everything is subjected to be destroyed by the terrorist ideology. If there is any ideology at all, you have to face them. Internal and external security have become so closely interlinked that today you cannot differentiate one from the other. Therefore, you are to learn. Every day you will get your own experiences, and you are the master. You are to interpret it. You are to apply your talents, intelligence, power of decision making to tackle that problem. And in that way, you will be the ears and eyes of the government. Even in the area of investigation of the crimes, you will find, as the stories are unfolding in the media of various terrorist activities which is going on, you will find that how closely they are linked with various aspects of our life. On the one hand, it is linked with the stories of deprivation, poverty, exploitation, non-availability, discrimination. On the other hand, even affluence also creates some sort of vacuum in the mind of the people, which leads to addiction to drug, to encourage narcotic business. And in the overall context, you will find there is a close link, drug trafficking, narcotic business, terrorist activities, unauthorized arms supply, closely linked and having a self-generating process of funding these activities. Therefore, in charge of the districts where you will be posted after a couple of years, as the superintendent of police, the most important ingredient, along with the district magistrate and collector of revenue. But revenue collection is no longer the primary responsibility of a district collector or a district magistrate. That has gone somewhere else. But your responsibility to ensure security, to provide security to the people, and to address all the issues connected therewith are your domain responsibilities. And therefore, as an elder man, my advice to you would be, don't think that you are completing your process of learning after your training in your academy for the next 30, 35 years. You will be a constant student. Combine in yourself the role of teacher, student, learner, and lesson giver. Because this is a lifelong experience. Many of you will go to the top of your profession. Professionalism, clinical detachment are essential ingredients to be a good police officer. Why I am talking of the clinical detachment? Because in practical life you will find that so many influences will come over you to influence your decision making, to influence your discharge your responsibilities. Because the complex political system in the country, they want to spread their influences and they would like to drag you in their network, while as an officer of the Republic, you are to dispense justice freely, fairly, without fear, without favor. So to combine these two responsibilities, you shall have to apply your intellect, and that will strengthen your character. On the one hand, you require a steely nerve, and on the other hand, you require a smiling face to show that nothing detracts you from your path of responsibilities. At the same time, you do not appear to show the ugly face, because your face is the face of the administration, face of the governance. I have departed from my written text only to share a couple of my perceptions about the young police officers, security officers, who are going to be the part of our integrated security system, which is the primary responsibility of the government. You are to subscribe oath and allegiance to the Constitution of India. The Constitution provides that as public servants, you are to discharge your responsibilities freely and fairly, without fear, without favor, because you are the face of the government. You are the dispenser of justice to the people. and you are to secure, provide security to them. I wish you all success in your career, and I do hope that you will follow the tradition which has been established by your predecessors. Immense sacrifices have been made. Many of them have lost their lives for the cause of duty, for the cause of motherland, to ensure that the others can sleep peacefully. You have given up your sleep. You have given up your comforts. You have given up everything to protect the people of this country for which you are oath bound. I wish you all success in discharging that responsibility. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Jai Hind.
Honorable President of India, Shri Pranab Mukherjee, Director Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, National Police Academy, Madam Aruna Bahuguna, members of the faculty and staff, fellow probationers, ladies and gentlemen. It is my proud privilege to present the vote of thanks on behalf of the Indian Police Service officers of 2015 batch and Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, National Police Academy. Respected sir, first of all, I would like to thank you for providing us with this wonderful opportunity to visit Rashtrapati Bhavan and the museum. And we witnessed its proud legacy, which shall stay as a cherished memory in our minds for years to come. Sir, we consider ourselves fortunate for your presence with us this evening and for sparing time from your busy schedule for a personal interaction with us. Today is a special day for all of us, as the interaction we had with you will be etched in our memories with unparalleled fondness and affection. Your inspiring words have reminded us that the greatest use of our life would be to spend it for something that will outlast it. I, on behalf of my entire batch, assure you that we will be working with utmost personal and professional integrity, dedicate ourselves in service of the nation, and keep public interest before self while discharging our duties. We shall act with responsibility and shall strive to strengthen the law and order machinery in our respective states. We shall put our sincere efforts to strengthen the fundamentals of the democracy and to uphold the Constitution in letter and spirit. We shall always remember that arriving at one goal is the starting point to another. Sir, we express our sincere gratitude to you for your time, thoughts, guidance, and inspiration. Thank you.